Hey friends, Dave Uloa, entrepreneur and founder of Living the Dream, Inc. And for those of you that don't know me, to give you a little background on myself, I was a former police officer with the LAPD, and I found myself, like a lot of people around the world, living paycheck to paycheck, basically looking for a better way of life. We were $70,000 in credit card debt. We had bought a house we could barely afford, and our relationship was struggling because we were struggling financially, and stress level, health was deteriorating, and we were looking for a better way of life. And I remember just going to bed at night saying, God, there's gotta be a better way. There's gotta be a different way of living. And here we live in the free world, in America, and yet we weren't living a free life. And I realized if I kept doing what I was doing, the next 30 years were gonna be the same, and I wanted something different. And so my wife and I, we went on our path of personal development and personal growth, and we started to learn and grow. And as we realized, if we wanted our outer world to change, we needed to change our inner world. And in less than 2 years, thanks to what we've learned, spending literally hundreds of thousands of dollars over the years in order to get trained by the best, we transformed our life. And in less than 2 years, we helped build a company that allowed us financial freedom. We helped to retire both sets of parents, and we traveled around the world and are just living a dream life. And I don't share that to brag. I share that in hopes to inspire you that no matter where you are in life today, maybe things are going good and you're saying to yourself, you know what, good isn't good enough. I want great, or I want an outstanding life. Or maybe you're struggling right now and you're living paycheck to paycheck, and maybe the bills are piling up and you're saying, you know what, this isn't what life's supposed to be about. I want more out of life. And so you're watching this video because you're like us. Nothing special. We were blue collar, and now we get to travel around the world inspiring people to truly live a dream life. And it's some of the things that we've learned that we want to share with you in hopes to help you to apply. And so we're going to give you the training and the philosophies. Today's a special philosophy that's dear to my heart that I want to share with you that literally changed our whole mindset. And then at the end, we're going to give you an action item. And we encourage you to take the action item. It's a simple item that you can just apply right away, because just hearing the information isn't going to make the transformation. It's about taking action on what you've learned. So every one of our videos is going to have an action item at the end that we encourage you to take action on that. And it's so simple. And today's philosophy that changed the entire game for us was, I actually learned it from my father. My father was a deli man for his whole life. He worked for several different delis, and sometimes he even had three jobs working for three different delis, and worked extremely hard. And a philosophy that he taught me was the philosophy of a business owner versus an employee. He shared with me the employee mindset is always the person that's going to get overlooked for the promotion. It's the person that wants to do the least amount of work and get paid the most. It's the employee mindset of just being comfortable, of just going to work and can't wait to come home and doing just what you're supposed to do, nothing more, just enough to keep that paycheck. That's the employee mindset. And there's so many people out there, and I don't know if you guys know, but statistics show that about 98% of the people around the world, by the time they hit the retirement age of 65, depend on their friends, their family, and the federal government as their main source of income. So what do the 2% know that the 98 don't? Well, my humble opinion is 98% of the people out there are having the employee mindset. And this has nothing to do whether you have a job or you have a business. I want you to understand the philosophy and the mindset. Then there's the business owner mindset, the business owner philosophy of getting there early before everybody else does and leaving the last one to leave, of doing more than your share to add value to the marketplace, to add value to the company, to add value to your business, more value than what you're supposed to, more information than you're supposed to give, doing more than everybody else. Once again, it doesn't matter whether you have a job or a business. This philosophy works for both. Because see, if you are working for somebody else and you have this mindset of a business owner, pretend that the company you work for, that you are the owner of the business. If you came in every day to work, would you work a little bit differently? Would you work a little bit harder? Would you work a little bit smarter? Would you have some ideas that might help the company save some money, to help the company grow? And if you shared those ideas, when your company came up for a promotion, who do you think would get it? See, here's the challenge is you gotta step outside of that comfort zone. And for most people, they wanna be inside of that comfort zone. And what tends to happen with the other employees that don't understand these philosophies and they wanna stay comfortable and wondering why they're always broke, they're the ones that are gonna be talking about you. They're the ones that are gonna be telling you, why are you working so hard? You're making us look bad. You need to slow down. They're the ones that are gonna be gossiping about you. And if you get your feelings hurt and you go back into what we call the sheeple of being with the sheep, you'll never live your dream life because you're just gonna wanna fit in. And I'm here to tell you, another philosophy, I'm giving you some good stuff, this one I'm gonna give you for free, is look at what the masses are doing and do the opposite. Look at what the masses are doing, on how they're acting, on where they're putting their money, on what they're doing with their life, and you do the opposite. If you wanna have a different way of life and stand out from everybody and have a truly dream life that serves and gives, do the opposite of everybody else. Because see, a business owner mindset, and if you are a business owner, even more so, put as much as you can into building your company and come from that place of, how can I add more value to the marketplace? Instead of just give me, give me, give me, give me, give me, how can I give, 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 and watch how your business transforms. As I shared with you, my dad, Galo Yuloa, was a deli man his whole life. And when he moved out here to California, he worked for a pretty famous deli. It's been in movies, and it's right over here on Fairfax called Cantor's. And he was a deli man there at Cantor's for many, many years. And one of the things that he did while he was there, he'd always ask himself this question. And Mark Cantor was his boss, one of the owners of the company of the deli. And he would always ask himself this question, how can I add more value to Cantor's? How can I help Cantor's save money? How can I help Cantor's make money? And one day he realized that the aluminum foil that they were using, when they would buy the aluminum foil, it came out in these boxes with the aluminum foil in there, and even these cartons that came in, and it would be to hold it so that you would actually use it. And my dad found out that you could actually buy the aluminum foil without the boxes it came in, and it would save a significant amount of money. And how much aluminum foil they were using every single day, every single week, they were buying dozens and dozens of these every single week, and the cost added up. So my dad decided, okay, well, if we can buy the aluminum foil separate without these little cardboard boxes that they send them in, then the company could save money. But in order to do that, we have to have something here that would hold the aluminum foil. And these are big aluminum foils that they would use because it was for a big business. And so my dad took one of the aluminum foils and he measured it, and he went home, and on his off time, he learned how to become a handyman. And he brought wood and these different types of materials and tested out different things, and eventually created this prototype that was made out of wood that didn't need to be replaced, that fit the aluminum foil, so that when he took it to Cantor's, they put the aluminum foil in there, and they don't have to buy the cardboard anymore where the aluminum foil came in, which started saving Cantor's hundreds and then eventually thousands and thousands of dollars. Now, my dad was only an employee there, and the owners of the company were so blown away that my dad, on his free time, created this out of his mind and out of his time, that it saved Cantor's thousands and thousands of dollars. And a lot of the employees there would joke around and they called my dad Gallo Cantor, because they were like, do you own this company? The way you treat how you work here, it's like you own it. My dad never owned any stock in the company. He wasn't a principal in the company. He was just an employee. But the one thing I will share with you is Mark Cantor and his family took incredible care of my father. That every year they gave him an incredible bonus. At Christmas time, he got an incredible bonus check. Why? Because it's not my dad asked for it. It's not because that's what he was expecting, but because he knew how to give and he knew how to serve and he had that business owner mindset. So today's action item is, what can you do today that's just a little bit more? What can you do today in your relationship that's just a little bit more? What can you do today at work that's just a little bit more? Or in your business that's just a little bit more? What can you do today? And so thank you, my friends. For those of you that would like to comment, I'd love to hear your comments on today's video on what you've learned, and also maybe share with us on some of the things that you want to learn so that we can help serve you and we could all live, thrive, and give together. Davey Loa signing off. Look forward to seeing you on the next video.